Hi, everybody. I'm very glad to participate in this event organized by Arnica. Thanks to Arnica. And first of all, I want to stress the moment related to Moldova, because we, together with Natalia, worked on that. That, in my view, it is a real problem that the compliance committee is looking very narrow to the disadvantages of concrete cases, not taking into account the wider approach related to general improvement of the situation in each party. And in my view, for example, for Moldova, the draft of the recommendations do not include the necessity of elaboration of the action plan, but only the plan of a solution of the concrete small issue related to reasonable prices for environmental information. In my view, in the last 10 years, the compliance committee has changed the approach in this direction. Do not do wider recommendations, but to do them very narrow, which is not, in my view, in favor of implementation of the convention in different countries. Now I am coming back to Turkmenistan. What has happened? In the beginning of 2000s, when practically Turkmenistan became the first country which by the presidential decree announced that it is a party of the convention. In reality, of course, in my view, they do not too much studied this document and simply signed it. In this moment, the situation in Turkmenistan in this moment was not the best one, because, for example, it existed the situation that legislation permitted only one NGO in each field of activity. Like in environment was a traditional post-Soviet society for nature conservation and nothing more. And in this respect, our friends who are really environmentalists from Turkmenistan had no right to establish the NGO, because it was a new type NGO and not the Soviet type, because usually Soviet type NGOs are managing by wives of hierarchies of these countries and so on. And in fact, this became the obstacle for the civil society to establish an NGO. And this was a reason why the ecological society Biotica, where I was a co-founder, applied to the compliance committee, and it was the fifth case in the compliance committee at all. It was not only the obstacle for NGOs. Another obstacle was that foreigners or apatrids could not establish or participate in functioning of any NGO, including environmental arms. This is a second point. Of course, we should understand that there are much more different obstacles created in this country, like in any autocratic regime, to not permit freely functioning of non-governmental organizations. And of course, compliance committee reacted. And the recommendations of compliance committee, including that the provisions of the law should include should be in compliance with the requirements of the convention, and the government should develop official guidelines for citizens and in general physics persons how to manage the NGO, and of course it should be equal access to national and international non-governmental organizations for everybody and not for only for Turkmen nationals. And of course, it was traditionally country was invited to submit a report to the meeting of the parties through the compliance committee. And the last point, and that international community, like international and regional organizations, also financial organizations, should provide advice and assistance to Turkmenistan to implement these measures. And despite of that, some period of about 10 years has gone, and it was amended the association law, but the key issue of impossibility for foreigners and apatrids to establish the NGO is saved. How it was saved? That the first article of the law on public association clearly limits the right to establish the NGO to only Turkmen citizens. Later, in different articles, it is named citizens or persons and so on. But anyway, the first article determines the content of the legislation. And despite of that, Turkmen authorities tried to explain that in the later articles is written more right than in the first article, but no any example of participation or in establishment of foreigners in establishment or in as member participation in any NGO exists. No practical examples. We did not found any substantial progress until 2017, when the party, the meeting of parties decided to recommend the party again to improve the situation until January 2020. And we see the clear situation when exists in the world and in UNEC region, the countries which do not like to implement the Aarhus Convention. And what to do with these countries, it is difficult to say. Because, for example, the countries are different. Some of them are not doing it because of cultural reasons and the long time tradition of the lack of democracy. In other countries, like Belarus, for example, I'm sure that if the regime will be changed, the situation will be cordially changed in the direction of improvement, of course, of the situation. So, in my view, we should answer to the question how such countries should be treated in frames of the international law. And in some cases, like Belarus, exclusion of Belarus from the process is not good. From the other country, from the other view, such countries which could not implement in near future the convention, is difficult to say what to say about them. Thank you.